Welcome back. So I got a piece of silver maple that I've had for a while. I just sealed the ends of it up with some latex paint. Had a crack here and then a crack on the bottom side, but I wanted to show you something. Whenever you're sourcing your wood, if you're getting some that's fallen down or somebody's cut down, something that you can do when you look at the outside of it, I'm gonna show the inside first. And when you look at the outside, you can see what's on the inside. So I don't know if you can see this streak right through here, little tight curls. Well, that is this streak right here. And you see these right here? You can kind of see them in the grain right here. And this long line right here is this line right here that goes through there. Pretty cool, huh? You can also see this knot's got some tight curls in it right there. And you can see it in the grain right in here. So that's one way to know what you're getting. And this is just cut with a chainsaw and you can still see it. Something pretty cool I figured I'd share with you that I figured out. Anyway, just a piece of silver maple. Don't know what I'm gonna do with it yet. I got the worm screw in, get it chucked up, and get this wonky piece off the side. since this thing has some nice figure in it. I'm gonna double that. This is some Keda dye that I've got mixed up. Some black. And I'm out of cotton pads, so. Gotta love her. Looks like I'm gonna be dyeing the whole thing black. Now you can really see where the changes in grain, excuse me, where the changes in grain are. Because that hard grain doesn't want to suck it in, and that'll soak in another color. We're gonna let this dry. Or speed it up. And since I'm going to use the bill buffing system on this one, gotta put some Danish oil on it. And all this is just a 2x4 that I put nails through and dremeled the heads down a little bit so they wouldn't stick into the wood. Just keeps from making an uneven finish on the bottom pieces. And since it's been a while since I've done one of these, where I kind of explained everything, I'm going to do that too. Now look, Mark, you got everything but the... Okay. And when you're putting this on, it's really, really going to soak in. Might end up having to put more in that little cup. And since this is pretty thin, it's unsaturated all the way through. Normally, we'll just keep drinking it. So I'm going to let this sit for about 15, 20 minutes. Let it dry out and cure some and come back and wipe it off.